right, folks, and welcome back to the Dawn of World Sports. I am the Dawn Father, and I'm now going to be covering a guy who I think, I'm not too sure, but I believe he has passed away now, so quite sad news. His name is Rick Rypien. He was an NHL player, and he was known for fighting. Not saying he wasn't a good hockey player, because I really couldn't speculate, as I do not know. But this video is entitled Top 10 NHL Hockey Fights of Rick Rypien, if that's how his name's pronounced. I believe it is. There will be a link to the original video in the description section below. If you want to watch it without me reacting, you can do so. Anyway, let's just get into it. I'm not going to fucking piss about anymore. I want to see some fucking top quality fighting. Let's go! Top 10 NHL hockey fights of Rick Rypien. Look at the aggressive face.
And in behind the play,
Christoph Tollefson.
Rypien and Tollefson. And Rypien got the first punch in.
Lovely left.
Got the first
three,
two.
Four, five. And that was fucking hell. As he's going down, he is not forgiven up. He is smashing him to pieces.
Tollefson keeps feeding him with the left.
He's feeding him with a left.
I love that. Come back. He takes one there.
He wants more.
Rick Rypien. All over.
He's absolutely annihilating him. There's not an awful lot coming back.
Takes one to give one. Comes up with an uppercut, and that will do it.
Lovely fight. Very explosive.
Little scrap going on.
Here we go. Gloves down. Six down.
Marcillo and Rypien.
Here he goes again.
Yep.
Look at the fucking left and the right's coming from Carcillo or Carcillo. Absolutely ferocious. That is phenomenal. He's giving him rights, he's giving him left. The sheer strength to hold themselves on their up on the feet as well. Brilliant power from both men. Look at him, he's threw him over. You just want to see him bulldozing his face into the fucking ice. Oh, look at that! Straight into the left, bang!
Now he lands a left.
Fucking knock him out! Mike Muir.
Boy, they're really tossing him. Not much.
Look at the left. Ferocious. He's rapping with him.
Left hand loose now.
Lovely stuff.
Rypien tags him again.
He's trying to make space for more of the left. The guy's going down. He's slipping about the place. You just know he's trying to unleash another left bomb.
So Hornacek in the box. And here's another
Brandon Prush.
And it's Rypien.
Here he goes again.
Brandon Prush, the tough guy.
His hands are like fucking lightning as well. He's great with both hands. Look at that. He smashed the fucking helmet off him. Absolutely brilliant. He's like a fucking pit bull terrier that cannot be stopped.
Scott, we've got a fight here.
Look at him. So explosive in the fight.
Into Zach Stortini. Now Stortini.
He's great with both hands, particularly the left. Every shot he's trying to knock you out. Very aggressive young man.
Here we go, Rick Rypien and Zach Stortini.
Round two. Lovely body shape from Stortini. Look at that. He is fucking him up.
Just couldn't get started. Wow, and it looks like the same thing here as Rypien continues to change.
He's going right, left, up top, into the body, under the arm, boom, boom. The combinations are absolutely frightening. Wow. Brad May.
Off, and Rick Rypien, he's going with him. May's fourth fight is the Red Wing.
May's unleashing some fucking bombs as well. Look at the change of hands from Rypien.
Got the left going and May protecting himself.
Wow, he is amazing.
Here we go. Scrap, Jansen, and Rypien drop the gloves.
He just fucking jumps into him there, look at that! He just goes fucking to town on cunts, man. This is pure entertainment. Imagine meeting this guy in a street fight, he would be your worst nightmare. He'd never stop. He'd never stop, even if you put him down, he'd just keep getting up. What a warrior.
What a scrap here.
Fucking pitbull.
And they are not done.
Ferocious.
And the big man bumps in front of the here
they might go.
Rypien,
he's got a hoodie of shirt.
And it looks like they want to go.
Let's fucking dance.
And they will.
Pressed again. This is the second fight in this video. Brilliant. Game as fuck. If you have them, love it.
The second round of this middleweight encounter between Rippon and
Price. Middleweight encounter. Wow. Really struggling to get the shots off here, but they're both trying their hardest to get balance, these guys can go to again. Throw punches. They really, really do want to fight, you can tell.
Rippon has got...
Yes! It was a bobby through.
What energy. What animosity these two men have for each other tonight.
It is absolutely gold. Gold.
Regaining his balance. Rippon with a couple of shots. Both men must be weary in their second fight of the hockey game.
This is the second fight of the same game. Bearing in mind they're playing hockey as well. I love how the refs are letting this one keep going.
Here they go again. Elbow pads flying, gloves. Erhoff making sure there's no danger.
Look at this. They are absolutely knackered, the two of them. That is absolutely brilliant stuff.
Now it's by Brian Lee. And now a fight in behind the play. Rippon gets in five quick ones on Chris Neal. Neal, the middleweight. Rippon, the lightweight in this one. And Rippon may have the fastest hands in the league.
He definitely got some of the fastest hands I've seen in the fight so far.
The right free, counters with a left hook.
My word. I love it. He's outsized by Neil. He's a middleweight, he's a lightweight. But that does not faze the man. That does not put him off at all. Does not deter him. He's got the spirit of a fucking pit bull. Go on! Go on! Love that. Fucking magic. Sorry. Technical difficulties because of me getting excited. That is the end of the video anyway. And I just showed a bit of the stuff at the end anyway, so that was the last fight. Just turn this camera around now. Wow! What a fucking little terrier this guy was. His hands were fucking rapid, like lightning. Bearing in mind, he's taking shots back. He does not give a fuck. He would walk through fucking hell and high water to fucking fight an opponent. He is absolutely... he is absolutely what I want to see in a player. If I was going to a hockey game, that ferocious and aggressive mentality that he has. He is afraid of no one. He is afraid of no challenge. No matter how big you are, no matter how heavy you are, no matter how aggressive you are, he is fired up and willing to take you on. I love how game he is. I just want to put one thing out here before I keep going on the rant. See if you think this is bad stuff. If you don't like this stuff, your NHL, oh, that's so violent. It's really not sporting at all. It's really not good to see. The kids shouldn't be watching this. Go and take a big flying fuck to yourself, you cunt. That is amazing stuff. Pure entertainment. That is better than the actual sport itself. Do you know what? I get entertained by, oh, you're Connor McDavid's. Love it. Great puck work. Great skill. Go around people. Leave them falling all over the place. But that gets me more fired up and more entertained and more... It just warms the cockles. It's really beautiful stuff to see. But the most fucking enjoyable thing about Rippon, or Rippon, or whatever way you pronounce his name, is the speed of his fucking hands is glorious. He's got great fucking punch variation, great combinations. He goes upstairs, downstairs, left, right, throws a series of lefts. All on ice, you've got to remember, he's on ice. He's trying to counter his balance as another man's pulling at him and also trying to swing digs. I love how he's first to get his fucking gloves off and his helmet off. No bullshit, just straight in. He is not afraid of any challenge from any man. Absolutely fucking brilliant. And as I've said, I'm not too sure if he's passed away. I think I've seen something about it, so it's very, very sad news. But he seemed to be a guy that I would have absolutely loved, and I mean loved, to go see play. Well, not play, you know what I mean, fight. That is magic. You do not know how lucky you are getting to watch that stuff. Do you know what's so good about it? If you go to boxing, you know you're going to get boxing. When you go to hockey, there's no guarantee that every game is going to result in a ferocious fight like that there. But you know in your heart of hearts, when he's available for team selection, that there's a huge chance of him exploding with someone and just getting it on. And that for me would be a huge reason to want to buy my ticket and go to the game, because you know that there is a chance if he plays, you're going to get a fucking epic fight. Some of those fights were insane, by the way. And credit to the other guys that were fighting them. Some of them were real tough cookies as well. I mean, they were taking some ferocious left hands and right hands. Body shots. I love the variation of them. For such a small guy, he's obviously got lightning quick hands, because the lighter the fighter, usually the quicker, the more of a volume of shots they can throw. Maybe with less power in it, but certainly a huge volume, and he's just picking people off bit by bit. His Pitbull personality is so endearing, it just makes you fall in love with him. Brilliant, brilliant fighter, great to watch. Thanks very much for the request, really enjoyed it, phenomenal stuff. As I said, no disrespect to the real hockey players, your McDavid's, your Crosby's, etc, etc, your Gretzky's, your Vetchkin's. It's a completely different aspect to the game. It's more about the game. As much as I really, really love watching it, and that's what hockey it should be about at the end of the day, that just makes me... Oh, the entertainment of it. It's like watching Cronwell with the big hits. That aspect, you just put all of these things into the sport, and I swear, you do not know how lucky you are to have such a fucking... amazing professional sport on your doorstep to watch. Really, really great stuff. Thanks again. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, guys, and share our videos with your friends and family. Make sure you put the notifications bell on as well so you don't miss any of our uploads when we upload. Also, check out our social media platforms in the description section below, and other ways in which you can help fund and support the channel as well. Don't forget to comment and leave a thumbs up. See you all soon. Goodbye.